Emotions ran high in the House Judiciary Committee today. Supporters and opponents of an anti-same-sex marriage bill packed the hearing room. Now, if you're of the same sex, you still can't get married here in the state, but the proposed legislation would close a loophole that does recognize same-sex marriages performed in other states. 11 News reporter David Collins joins us live from Annapolis tonight with the very latest. David?
Well, Stan, the bill is a preemptive strike against an opinion on the issue, highly anticipated opinion, from the state attorney general's office.
It's against the natural order. It's bad policy, social policy, it's bad economic policy, it's bad political policy, and more importantly, it's bad educational policy.
Baltimore County Delegate Emmett Burns, who's also a pastor of a Baptist church, is leading the charge to strengthen a Maryland law defining marriage as a union between one man and one woman. His bill is a preemptive strike against a highly anticipated upcoming opinion by the state attorney general that many believe will open the door for Maryland to recognize same-sex unions performed in other states.
If it's not in place, the attorney general has a free hand to rule as he wishes.
But are there any other proposed rule changes that need to be discussed before the bodies?
The Maryland General Assembly has granted a number of legal protections for same-sex couples. It created a process allowing them to be recognized as domestic partners, including an exemption from inheritance taxes, the right to make medical decisions for one another, the right to visit their partner in the hospital, and to share a nursing room home.
We are a state that likes to press forward. This is a bill that would move us backward.
Six states in D.C. now recognize same-sex unions, but in the past year, New York and California rejected same-sex policies.
This isn't deciding the question of same-sex marriage, but what we are saying is that question should be decided by the legislature, by the people of Maryland.
The House has enough votes to pass a marriage equality bill. The more conservative Senate is two votes shy. The advocacy group Equality for Maryland is targeting the seats of elected officials who stand in the way.
In the coming elections this year, we will certainly be protecting those who have stood up for equality, and we will be putting a stake in the ground in the people who are out there telling hateful stories and spreading baseless rhetoric.
At the witness table, Delegate Burns tried to put to rest any comparison same-sex marriage advocates are making to the civil rights movement.
I cannot hide my color. I don't want to. I'm proud to be who I am. But those who were of a different sexual orientation could.
Similar bills have come up four times since 1996. All have failed. The state attorney general's opinion is expected to come out in the coming weeks. Reporting live from Annapolis, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.